Arizona state parks have not received appropriations from the state's general fund since 2009. The agency is now expected to be self-sustaining, but the new state parks director has identified some critical funding issues, and he's asking for $15 million to be included in the next state budget. Here to talk about that and his strategies for improving the agency is state parks director Bryan Martyn. Good to meet you. Thanks for being here.
Chad, my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
What is the current state of Arizona state parks?
You know, we're doing well. We're doing a lot better than we were in the past. You know, in the past, they looked at parks kind of like a museum or a library, where it really didn't matter if you made money. It was kind of a social contract you had with society. And these days, we have to look at parks as being self-sustaining. You've got to make money. And that's kind of where we're at. We're trying to figure out how to keep our parks running efficiently and make money where we can.
I know that some critics would say doing better is one thing, but doing well would be another. They see some noticeable deterioration out there. How would you respond to that?
Yeah, I would say it's a marathon. It's not a sprint. We're moving forward slowly. We do understand that funds are limited throughout the state. You can't expect to just raise your hand and get money thrown at parks. There are a lot of other obligations that are out there. We have to demonstrate our worth to communities throughout Arizona.
Talk about the budgetary concerns here, what you're faced with and what you're asking for.
You know, our budget has been reduced dramatically. And what we've asked for, as every agency in Arizona, there are over 80 different agencies that they all ask for what they can get. We've asked for those things that I like to call tires and gas. State parks is kind of like a car running down the road at 100 miles an hour, and it has bald tires. You know you've got some things that you need to fix, and you don't know when they're going to go. So what you hope for is to get some money to get some new tires to keep your parks going. Because if they go down, the car's not going anywhere. And that's one of the big things. And then the gas part, we talk about enhancing our parks so they can make more money.
Indeed. And state parks, this is an enterprise agency. Explain what that means.
Well, we eat what we kill. Basically, you know, we have to go out and make money, and that's the basics of it. We're not on the general fund. We're one of about three states in America that are not on the general fund, and that is what it is. And our job is to demonstrate why it's important that we get help from communities and friends groups, and we demonstrate our worth every day.
If it is what it is now, does it always have to be that way? Can that change? Can the state show a little more impetus in helping these parks succeed?
Well, there's no doubt. I mean, the Arizona State Parks has friends throughout the state and throughout the legislature, and the governor is a big fan of Arizona State Parks. Make no mistake, more and more they understand the value of state parks, but there are limitations on what funds are available. My job is to demonstrate these are our needs, these are the funds that we've asked for. If you have the ability, where that cut line is, and we have no idea where that cut line is, it would be great to get some funds.
Any indication that you will get some funds?
It's difficult to say. We have no idea. We've got things that, well, we argue the effect of Obamacare and those things on the state, and we don't know how much revenue we have out there. My job as the director of the agency, on the business end of the deal, is to put forward a request and justify that request, and then just wait and see.
The request involves what? Capital projects, maybe operations, staff, the whole nine yards?
The whole nine yards, very much the tires and the gas. I mean, I have sewage treatment plants that are 40 years old. That goes down, the park theoretically goes down. That's one of those tires. And we try to get money for those things. And then if we electrify a campground, why get more people in the campground? The rates for being in the campground are raised, and that's kind of our guess. We make more money.
The car analogy, we can say that I know that there are some lawmakers who don't think that the state should be in the car in the first place. How do you convince them that state parks are important to Arizona?
You know, this is one of our resources in Arizona, and the reason state parks came around in the first place was to assist those rural communities. There are no state parks right now in Maricopa County that are operated by the park system. So our parks are out in these rural communities, and they're economic drivers for these communities. That's part of our obligation in Arizona, to take this resource and make it enhance the communities, get people to these smaller communities.
You referred to this earlier with the idea of financial partners. What's the status of that, and how can you improve on that particular dynamic?
We are very blessed in state parks. We've had a lot of people really step up, friends groups, individuals, counties, cities, tribes, have given money to help keep parks open, their park open, because they understand the benefit of that park as an economic driver. These groups, they're getting tired. I mean, they continue to give and give and give. Our job is to continue to embrace them. We put our arm around them and thank them and give them loving, and they continue to make our parks great. But eventually, those people aren't going to have the resources. We'll continue to use their time. The important part, Ted, is I need more people. We need more citizens who are willing to step up and help. I mean, I ask for a weekend a year. That's all I ask. If you can spend 2 days a year at a park, everything from pulling weeds to greeting people, you know, as they come in, that's great benefit added.
But last point, I know a lot of citizens would say we need to see more of a commitment from the state. How hard are you going to push on this?
I'm pushing as hard as I can. You know, we work hard every day educating legislators on the value. You can't just go ask for something. We just don't have those kinds of resources in Arizona. As a prior elected, I understand. You know, a lot of people have their hand out. Arizona State Parks needs to demonstrate the value of the investment. You are investing in Arizona State Parks, and there is a return monetarily and to our citizenry and our guests.
All right. Bryan, it's good to have you here. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Ted, I really appreciate the time.
Thank you.
Thanks.